Hello friends, welcome back to Apple Friendly. Today, I'm gonna walk you through all the important settings about Notes app on your iPhone. This will help you to use Notes on your iPhone effectively. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Launch Settings on your iPhone and look for Notes. The first preference you need to set up is Default Accounts. Now here, you should find all the different accounts that support Notes app, like iCloud, Gmail, Yahoo, etc. I personally recommend to keep iCloud as your default account because it will sync your notes seamlessly across all Apple devices with the same iCloud account. Now the next setting is On My iPhone Account. Well, if you put this toggle on, it will create an additional folder in Notes app. All the notes under this folder will not be synced across iCloud servers and will always remain only on your iPhone. I'd recommend to keep this toggle off because you may lose your notes if they are not in sync with iCloud and something bad happens to your iPhone. Better is to keep your notes in sync with iCloud always. In the next settings, you can choose the preference to sort your notes. My favorite is Date Edited, because I can always have my last edited note right on the top of the list. You can choose as per your preference. The next setting is New Notes Start With. Here, you can select the default format for the new notes. You have title, heading, and body. For all those who don't know the difference, this is how different formats look like. You can always change these formats in Notes app. So the preferred setting here is body. Now the next setting is lines and grids. These lines and grids are useful for handwriting and drawing in Notes app. For example, this is how the canvas will look like when handwriting in Notes. Now the next setting is password. This is my favorite setting in Notes app, and I highly recommend to password protect your important and private notes. You should also use Touch ID or Face ID to view locked notes. Now here, you have got two different options: Change Password and Reset Password. These two are very different, and I have a step-by-step tutorial just on the password settings in Notes app. It's a beautiful tutorial, and I highly recommend everyone to watch it if you wanna know the exact difference between these two options. I'll put the tutorial link in the cards as well as in the description below. Do check that out. Now the next setting that we have is Save to Photos. It is recommended to keep this toggle on because it will save all the photos that you take inside Notes app to your Photos app. So you'll always have a backup of photos in your Photos app. Now the last setting that we have is Access Notes from the lock screen. Well, here you've got three different options. You can keep it off, or you can always create a new note whenever you access notes from the lock screen. This helps to quickly take the notes without unlocking your iPhone. And another setting is Resume Last Note. This will not create a new note when you access notes from the lock screen. Rather, it will launch the previous note that you had accessed based on your preference. You have got two preferences here. Either you can resume the last note that you had created on the lock screen, or you can resume the last note that you had viewed in the Notes app. For both these options, you have got additional settings. Like when you want to resume the last note that you had created on the lock screen, you can select the time frame after which a new note will be created rather launching same old note. On the other hand, when you want to resume the last note that you had viewed in the Notes app, you need to select the time frame after which it should ask for the password to view your notes. Always is better. But choosing between the two, I'd recommend to select Always Create New Note option for the privacy and simplicity. And this brings me to the end of the video. I hope this helps to know how to set up setting preferences for Notes app on iPhone. If you found it useful, do let me know down in the comments below and share it with your friends and loved ones. I'll see you soon in the next one. This is Vikas signing off. Thank you so much for watching.